at the ban of the veil, because we can see what is beyond that. The matter does not stand by asking a ban on the minaret of the mosque, because minaret of mosque is not going to attack any person. They stand still in their places, but still they have turned to be an object of aggression to them in Switzerland, for example, because there is more to come. The next step would be about the mosque itself, about the gathering in the mosque itself. So in the same way, we understand that a ban on veil or burqa, that is just a pretext to undermine the Islamic values, one after the one. This is why I would say to those people who think that because veiling is not seen as mandatory with the majority of the Muslim scholars, then why not to ban it? I would say to them, this issue is an internal issue among the Muslims. Like all other debates, like all other issues, there might be two opinions about that as well. According to the majority of the scholars, Imam Malik, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi'i, yes, the screening of the face or veiling is not mandatory, but it is recommended, highly recommended, especially for those who were gifted with more beauty among the women. That is highly recommended for them according to these three jurists. And according to Imam Ahmad, it is mandatory. It is wajib. So this is a difference of opinion among the scholars. But even those who said that it is not recommended, it is not mandatory, but it is recommended, their practice is, throughout the century was, to give preference to the veil. This is why, up to this century, the last century, the common norm in the Muslim society was al-burqa and veiling the face. But with our countries colonized, with more and more inspiration from the Western culture, the lighter opinion, and that is about hijab, which means to cover the face, which means to cover the head, not the face and the hands, was widely adopted. So that was an internal debate among the Muslims. But it does not give any license to the people to say that one of these opinions should be excluded completely and a ban should be introduced on the veil. Now let me explain these ayats, which says very clearly about the concept of that purity. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. Say to the believers, lower their gazes and guard their modesty. ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. This is to bring more tazkiyah, more purification to them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better what they do. وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنْ. And say to the believing women, lower their gazes. وَيَحْفَظْنَ فُرُوجَهُنْ. Guard their chastity. وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا. And they should not expose their zina, their beautification, except what becomes apparent by itself. That is the main object or the main wordings which has created the difference of that opinion, of two opinions. إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا. What type of zina should be exposed and what type of zina beautification should not be exposed. It is very clear, وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا. They must not expose out of their beautification what is exposed by itself. So what is that thing which is exposed by itself? Zina, they say that one zina which is created by Allah, and that is the face. And the other zina which is artificial. For example, having alcohol in the eyes, bangles in the hand, and earrings. This is that zina which is artificial. So according to Abdullah ibn Masud, what is meant is the first thing, that zina means the face itself. So this is why he said that the women have to conceal their faces or veil their faces except the outer garment, which are seen by the people, which are zahir, which are exposed, whatever dress they are wearing. And the other opinion of Abdullah ibn Abbas, who said that it means that they must not expose their whole body except for face and the hands. These two things are exempted. So this is why the difference of opinion comes between the jurists. And we have to see from the other evidences that some evidence support the first view and the other support the second view. For example, those people who say, yes, the veiling is mandatory, they would say that the Prophet ﷺ said about a woman who is in the state of ihram. So there are so many restrictions for the woman in the state of ihram. And he said, لَا يَنْتَقِبْ الْمَرْأَةُ الْمُحْرِمَةُ وَلَا تَلْبَسِ الْقُفَّازَيْنِ. A woman in the state of ihram should not wear niqab and should not wear gloves. So it means that niqab was a practice. Only in the state of ihram, she was asked not to wear niqab. And in the same way, she must not cover the hand as well with something which is sewn, and that is the gloves. And they would also say, for example, this woman, Umm Khallad, who came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, her son was martyred in a battle. So she was in the state of a distress, something, a calamity has happened to her. But she came with the veil on her face. And someone said to her that you are still in your veil and you got such a big calamity. Your son has died and still you are concerned with your veil. And she said, فَقَدْتُ إِبْنِي وَلَمْ أَفْقَدْ حَيَائِي. I have lost my son, not my modesty, not my haya. And in the same way, it was said that Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was seen by the people doing tawaf, وَكَانَتْ مُتَنَقِّبَةً. And she got a veil upon herself. And there are other supportive ahadith for that opinion as well. And the biggest or the most strongest opinion is the ayah of Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said to the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُنَّ مَطَاعًا فَسَأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَاءِ حِجَابٍ. Whenever you ask anything from the wives of the Prophet, then ask it beyond al-hijab. And there should be a screen between you and them. So they must not be seen by you. So it means that if you approach them in their houses, then you have to converse with them beyond this hijab. And if they come, then they carry their hijab with them. And carrying hijab means having their burqa or burqa upon them, and that is their hijab. The other people would say that this is an injunction for the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam alone. The whole